Hello and welcome to Lamplighter. Today is May 8. We are continuing to work our way through a long list of psalms, and we've been on this list of psalms now for several days, as you well know. But remember, there are 150 psalms in the Bible, and we're looking at a large section of them right now. Specifically, we're looking at a group of psalms that the editor has grouped together, and he calls them psalms expressing a variety of sentiments. And we've been seeing some of the emotions of the psalmists as they wrestle with themselves and as they wrestle somewhat with God. Those are the kinds of feelings that probably we all have experienced from time to time. And so we can find these psalms to be very helpful in knowing how to deal with our own emotions and knowing how to deal with God, who continues to love us, who continues to reach out his love to us, and who seeks to bless us. What a wonderful God we serve. Today we begin reading at Psalm 111. This one is entitled, Fearing a Loving God is the Beginning of Understanding. And here again, this idea of fearing God is not necessarily talking about being afraid of him, but it's talking about having this healthy respect or reverence for God, recognizing who he is, recognizing what he has done and what he continues to do to bless his people, including ourselves. We read some excerpts like these. Great are the works of the Lord. They are pondered by all who delight in them. This is an encouragement for all of us to take some time every single day to meditate. Why not just stop for a few minutes and reflect on what God has done for us? Reflect on what God is continuing to do, to ask ourselves that all-important question, what is God up to in my life right now? What is he hoping that I see? What is he hoping that I recognize? And how is he hoping I might react to the circumstances of my day? We read, the Lord is gracious and compassionate. He remembers his covenant forever. These are words that are used to describe God all the way through Scripture. Gracious and compassionate. God feels what we feel. God wants to encourage us to be a holy people. And he remembers the covenant that he made long ago with Abraham. He remembers all of the covenants that he has made with his people throughout the pages of time. And when we start to appreciate who God is and what he has done and what he continues to do, then we have a new kind of understanding that will help us in our everyday walk. We move on to Psalm 130. This one is entitled, Only Hope of Redemption is in God's Forgiveness. That's kind of an understatement, isn't it? We know that the only hope we have for life beyond this one is that God take care of our sin problem, because we're all sinners, as we talked about yesterday. Here the psalmist writes, If you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand? But with you there is forgiveness. Therefore, you are feared. It's because God loves us, he forgives us. He makes a pathway to himself for us through his Son. And that's why we honor him. That's why we fear or respect or even reverence him, because he has done all of this that we don't even deserve. We go to Psalm 131. It's a very short psalm that is just a very basic expression of quiet humility. This would do us good to read from time to time to remember who we are and what our place is in relation to this great God, that we are undeserving, that we are unworthy, and so we humble ourselves in his presence. Psalm 141 is a prayer for the wise use of one's speech. Who couldn't use this advice? As we read some excerpts on page 379, the psalmist asks this and makes this plea. Set a guard over my mouth, O Lord. Keep watch over the door of my lips. Let not my heart be drawn to what is evil, to take part in wicked deeds with men who are evildoers. Let me not eat of their delicacies. Let a righteous man strike me. It is a kindness. Let him rebuke me. It is oil on my head. My head will not refuse it, but my eyes are fixed on you, O sovereign Lord. That's a prayer, again, I think that all of us could pray. We need to guard our lips. We need to be careful about the things we say and the kind of activities in which we engage ourselves. And then finally today, we move on to Psalm 146. The God who cares is the God to trust. Praise the Lord, O my soul, the psalmist writes. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, the maker of heaven and earth, the sea and everything in them, the Lord who remains faithful forever. That's the key. He remains faithful forever, even when we ourselves are not faithful. He upholds the cause of the oppressed and gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets prisoners free. The Lord gives sight to the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the alien and sustains the fatherless and the widow, but he frustrates the ways of the wicked. The Lord reigns forever. Your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord. Our Lord, our God, is worthy of our praise. Isn't it great to be a lamplighter? His word is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. I hope you have a blessed day.